Hi, it's John Mitchell, Mayor of New Bedford, and I'm here today to talk about an important weapon in our war against the coronavirus. We've talked a lot about social distancing, of course. Keeping people away from one another is the best way to stem the transmission of the virus. But good personal hygiene is also an important facet of the overall effort. And among the things that you can do to improve, we can all do, starting with me, can do to improve personal hygiene is to make sure that we wash our hands thoroughly. And this is something that I think we're all doing a lot more of today, but there's a way to do it that can actually improve our chances of avoiding the virus. We all know that that doctors do this constantly. If you go to a doctor's office, they wash hands in between appointments, one after another. They're doing it constantly, and there's a way to do it the right way. So I figured, well, let's try to learn that and without having to pay the tuition for medical school. So I ordered up a house call of sorts to somebody who that I know very well, the First Lady of New Bedford, Ann Partridge, my wife, who is a breast oncologist at the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute in Boston, and who, in addition to being on the faculty at Harvard Medical School and also Dana-Farber, also has a master's in public health. And so, and she, most importantly, is the person who tells me all the time to wash my hands. So I wanted to share the experience with all of you. So, dear, could you tell us how it's done?
Sure. And I think it's important first to talk about when we should wash our hands. So when do we wash our hands when we walk into the Mitchell house, should we have to go out?
When my wife tells me.
No, what if she's not there?
I wash them when I walk in the door before I eat.
Perfect, perfect. And if you're doing food prep, like many of us are doing, either for our husbands or our wives or partners or for our children, or if you work in the industry where you're doing food prep, you know, the sign on the bathroom, don't go back without washing your hands before you start any shift, after you touch your face or do anything personal, you're gonna wash your hands again. And there is a right way to do it. But you wanna remember that. It's not just about coming in from the outdoors, it's before you do food prep for other people or before you eat yourself.
All right,
important
us,
times.
Please.
All right, so there is actually a science to this, and I'm guilty, like many of us historically, of I wash my hands a lot, but often it's kind of a, in this era of the COVID virus, we need to be that much more fastidious about it. So you're washing your hands because there could be the virus on it. Maybe I came in and touched somebody or needed to touch a door handle for some reason. So you turn on the water, you wet your hands, you grab your soap. Okay, all good, all potentially contaminated, right? You've touched everything. You gotta get it all nice and soaped up inside, that feels good. And most of the time I used to just kind of wipe them off and be done, but nowadays you gotta, and if you're operating on someone or anything like that, surgeons taught us best, you wanna make sure you're getting between the fingers. Really important, we didn't think much about that in the past. You wanna get the knuckles, all right? You actually, especially if you're doing a lot of work with your hands, you wanna get the under the nails, all right? And everybody's heard the happy birthday. You sing happy birthday twice. You should be doing it enough times. Another trick I've heard is to do the whole alphabet. If you know two languages, you should do it in the language that's harder for you, because that might just take a little bit longer. All right, all of that together is that full 20 seconds of hand washing that you're supposed to have. And then you rinse them off really, really well. If you're someone who's been blowing your nose or coughing into some place like this, and you can wash that part too, you wanna wash that part too. Okay, so get everything clean, and then here's the biggest trick. You got your paper towel, or your hand towel. Use paper right now. Don't use cloth towels if you don't have to, because then you gotta wash them after you wash your hands. So we're using a lot of paper these days. And then another trick is to take your towel, and then that knob that you turned on, turn it off with the towel, and then just throw the whole thing out in the nearby garbage. And that way you haven't touched anything that you touched right before you washed your hands.
Perfect. So now we can all wash our hands like doctors. But in all seriousness, this is vitally important as we do everything we can, all the little things, to ensure that we're all safe during this period. Thank you, everybody.